Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. In this week's discussion on the celestial sphere, we are going to talk about the hour angle and see what that means. So let's go ahead and get started. And what do we mean by the hour angle? Well, it's another way of being able to measure positions on the sky. And we're going to specifically look at what is called the local hour angle. Now, the local hour angle is related to the right ascension of a star. And if you remember, we had right ascension and declination as two coordinates, as shown in the image here, and that the declination was how far you were above or below the celestial equator. And the right ascension was then measured along the celestial equator from the vernal equinox. And a big difference is that when we look at the hour angle, it is still measured along the celestial equator. It is generally measured in hours rather than degrees, just like right ascension. And the difference is that the right ascension is fixed. When you have the coordinates of the star, the right ascension is always the same value. However, the local hour angle will change over time. It will not remain the same. So we've had various different coordinate systems we've looked at. We looked at altitude and azimuth, where everything changes. Both the altitude and azimuth will constantly change over the course of a day. We looked at the equatorial coordinate system, in which case the coordinates never changed because of the motion during the course of a day. So here we have one that's fixed, so the declination would still remain the same always, but the hour angle will then change. So how do we calculate the local hour angle? Well, it is equal to what is called the local sidereal time, and you subtract the right ascension from that. So the local sidereal time is the time relative to the stars. So the time we normally use here on Earth is solar time. We measure things relative to the sun, and that's what takes 24 hours. For a star to get back in the same position on the sky, it takes 23 hours and 56 minutes. So the sidereal day is about 4 minutes shorter than the solar day. So the time is slightly off there. Now, what do we learn from this when we actually use it? Well, the local hour angle, when that's equal to zero, that means that the object is on the meridian. So the meridian would be the due south line going from the North Pole through the south. So it would tell you when the sun or other object is on the meridian. And when it's zero, that means that's where it's located. And it's also at its highest point in the sky. We call this a transit, as it transits the meridian. And that is when the local hour angle is zero. Now, if the local hour angle is less than 0 hours, then the object is to the east. It's risen but has not yet reached the meridian. And the value of the local hour angle will then tell you how long before it does reach the meridian. So if the local hour angle were 2 hours, then you'd know that 2 hours later, that object would be transiting the meridian. It would be highest in the sky. If the local hour angle is greater than zero, then the object is in the west, so it's already past the meridian. And that can tell you then how long ago it transited the meridian. And of course, if you add the 24 hours to it, then you'd get back to where it would be on the meridian again. So it really can tell you roughly when the object is going to be transiting and when it is going to be highest in the sky, when it would be best visible. So if you find that hour angle when it's at zero, that's when you generally want to observe, because the object will be highest in the sky, will be traveling through the least amount of atmosphere, and therefore be the best time for observing that object. So essentially what we've seen is that the time then tells us how long before it reaches the meridian or how long ago it did pass the meridian. So let's go ahead and finish up here with our summary. And what we've looked at today is, first of all, that the local hour angle is related to the right ascension of an object. We can calculate it using the local sidereal or star time and the right ascension. And it can tell us how long before the object reaches the meridian, which will be its highest point in the sky. So that concludes this discussion on the hour angle. We'll be back again next week for another discussion on a topic of the celestial sphere. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.